bit, and yet some of the same thoughts that we've been preaching. One verse I want to read to you in the closing of the Bible. Now, all through the scripture, I started with you in Matthew. I'm going back to the Old Testament in just a moment for at least one scripture. Maybe a couple we'll get back there, but we'll come through several of the New Testament books. We'll come through John's writing, Luke's writing, Mark's writing. We'll come through Acts. We'll come through Romans, and many more could be given to you from the other books of the Bible, but here's the last book in the Bible, one verse. I want you to listen. I'm going to read it, emphasize every point, and reread it. I want you to get the thought fully that God left no one out in the last invitation that's ever given in the Bible. And the Spirit and the bride say, come. Let him that heareth say, come. Let him that's athirst come. And whosoever will, let him take of the water of life freely. Now, I want you to look at that verse. If you're blessed to have a Bible and you have the opportunity to open your Bible, I want you to do it and read this verse with me. If not, take note and get every statement. The Spirit and the bride. Now, without taking all the time and taking doctrine and prove what he's saying, he's talking about the great Holy Spirit of God. That's the third person in the Godhead we're taught in the Bible. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. And this Holy Spirit was sent back. God sent the Holy Spirit back. Christ said, I'll pray and my Father will send that. And we have the record in Acts chapter 2 where the Holy Spirit came back and he empowered that church on the day of Pentecost and made the church able to have the power to witness for our Lord all over the entire world. That's the Spirit he's talking about. Now, John 16 tells us, if you read 14, 15, and 16, you'll find much taught in the Gospel of John about the work of the great Holy Spirit. And you'll find some of the work is for us to say, to teach us and to lead us and guide us and comfort us, ever born again.